You know, there's something about being Black and Seventh-day Adventist that unlocks a person's potential and enables them to perform exceptional feats for the benefit of humanity. Here are 30 such individuals that I want to share with you. William J. Hardy was the first Black person elected to office in the state of Michigan, and he was elected in 1872. His son Eugene was the first Black to graduate from high school in the state of Michigan, and he graduated in 1877. Jesse Dorsey Green co-founded Voorhees College with Elizabeth Evelyn Wright in 1897. Mabel Branch was the first Black teacher of public schools in the state of Colorado. That was 1898. Lottie Blake was the only Black woman physician in Birmingham, Alabama in 1901. Anna Knight was the first Black woman of any denomination to serve as a missionary in India, and she sailed to India in 1901. Mary Britton was the first woman licensed as a medical doctor in the state of Kentucky. That was in 1902. Franklin H. Bryant was the first Black law graduate at the University of Colorado, and he graduated in 1907. James Childs, in 1910, argued the Chesapeake and Ohio Railroad case for racial desegregation before the U.S. Supreme Court. Ruth Temple was the first Black woman to practice medicine in Los Angeles, California. Eva B. Dykes, and you know where I'm going with this, was the first Black woman to complete the requirements for a PhD, which she did in 1921. As placid as Irene Morgan looks right here, she refused to give up her seat on a Greyhound bus. And when she was jailed, she took the state to court and won the case. And that decision outlawed racial segregation on interstate buses. That's 1944. Rothacker Child Smith served as a medic in World War II, a so-called Buffalo Soldier. During one battle, he was wounded and captured by Germans, but he escaped just before the close of the war. That was in 1944. Mary Inez Booth formed a prison ministry group that visited jail every Saturday to encourage prisoners. She continued going to jail every week for 55 years. Terrence Roberts was a member of the Little Rock Nine, and by his courageous act, dealt a blow to racial segregation in schools in America. Yolanda Clark sang with her choir at the March on Washington and stood right behind Martin Luther King Jr. as he delivered his "I Have a Dream" speech. In 1972, Robert Cherney designed the tires for the moon buggy used during the Apollo 15 mission. He also invented interstellar commodes. C.D. Brooks was the speaker director of Breath of Life Ministries, the first continuously running Black religious television programming. and that began in 1974. The National Association for the Prevention of Starvation, or NAPS, was formed at Oakwood College and comprised of its students with the goal, quote, to eliminate hunger, poverty, and disease, and to improve education and food security among suffering people, both nationally and internationally, regardless of race, religion, or nationality. NAPS has been awarded by several national governments for their humanitarian work. Richard and Carolyn Bland began United Prison Ministries International, a ministry that visited more than 3,000 prisons in 50 states, as well as Africa, Europe, and Asia, and distributed some 75 million pieces of spiritual literature. And it began in 1980. Mary Kate Stovall Tapley was the first black mayor of Hertzboro, Alabama, and she was elected in 1984. Ben Carson, in 1987, performed the first successful separation of conjoined twins. Frank Hale Jr. is the first black person to have a building named after him on the Ohio State University campus. And Hale Hall was inaugurated in 1989. In 1989, Chessie Harris received the President's Volunteer Action Award from George Bush for her humanitarian work for thousands of disadvantaged children in Alabama. David Williams developed the Everyday Discrimination Scale, one of the most widely used measures of discrimination in health studies. As health czar of the city of Philadelphia, Gwen Foster led the residents of the city to lose more than 76 tons of weight in 76 days. And that was in 2001. In 2003, Barry Black became the first black person to be elected chaplain of the United States Senate. Ella Simmons is the only woman to be a vice president of the General Conference of Seventh-day Adventists. She is the highest ranking female official in the history of the denomination, with the exception of three women treasurers in the pioneer era. James Graves Jr. is the second black to be elected to the United States Court of Appeals, and he was appointed by President Obama in 2010. And finally, Lloyd Henry was the first African-American to complete the Ironman Globe Finisher, and he has completed 21 Ironman competitions in total.